Greetings of the day. Myself, I'm Vinay. Today, I'm here to give a lecture on the food and beverage operations, which is semester 3 and 4. The topic is on beer. This basically, in last class, we already discussed about the types of beer. Last class, we discussed about the production of beer and introduction, as well as we discuss even the history about. Today, in this class, I'm going to discuss on types of beers as well as storage of beer. These are the two subtopics which I'm going to cover up. So number one is a type of beers. So in this type of beer, how this types of beers are made, how it is been classified, we are going to see in this topic. Number one, we have two types of beers. One is, in general, it's called as a stronger beer, and second one, it's been lighter beer. On what basis it's been classified? Not it based on color, flavor, or taste. It being classified in terms of like fermentation process. The basic fermentation process at time of fermentation tanks, when the type of yeast you add into it, that makes a difference. The process involved in that, based on that, the type of beer is made or it been classified. You might get a doubt. Sometimes the beer is very strong. Generally, it has a very good color, a very good strong flavor. Taste will be sweeter, but it called as a light beer. Hey, sir, how can it be possible? It's very strong color, like good alcohol power. But even though it called as a lighter beer, sometimes you have a very light, mild flavor, mild taste, but sometimes it called as a strong beer. So it is not, as I told earlier, it is not classified on the color, taste, and flavor. It is being classified on type of fermentation and what kind of yeast you added into that. So let's start the class, the types of beer. Number one, I want to speak on stronger beer. How it is made? That when we take at the fermentation, when you add this yeast called as a Saccharomyces cerevisiae, when we put that yeast in the fermentation tanks, the yeast will remain on the top and it start acting. The yeast started eating the sugar and releases the ethyl alcohol and carbon dioxide, but the temperature should be given at 15 to 20 degrees. And this happens, this fermentation will happen the top of the tank. This is called top fermentation and it is made in open vessel. By this, you're going to get the alleys, porters, stouts. You can see my cursor. This is called type of a beer called alleys, pots, and stout beer. This is a type of famous beers which you get in the, like, you know, identified the most famous. This is a stronger type of a beer where you get in the market. And also, we have a few varieties or the types of in stronger beer. We call it as a bitter ale, brown ale, cream ale, Indian pale ale, mild, porters, scotch, stouts, and whiz. This is a type of a stronger beer we're going to discuss individually, how it is made, and a little bit of explanation where they are from, how it is come. We'll try to see into that. So this is the first one, in stronger version. I'm going to talk on the bitter ale. The basically amber color, this is a type of beers which has come from the, like, you know, amber is a golden color. See the beer color, how it is light golden color. This is called amber, amber colored beer. And hops, you know about hops, I believe. Last class I told about this one, but still I show the picture. You can see my cursor. This is called the hops. It come from the luminous family. It's a kind of a plant. So basically these hops give a good flavor, floral flavor to the drink. Hop flavor it has, very nice hop flavor, and bitter in taste. It has a bitter in taste, some unique distinct style of kind of a beer it is. And it has a very low alcohol, 3 to 5%, but it has a very stronger version. And the best, the people say, well, can we get some special or the best, they try to offer the bitter. So how this bitter, it's a stronger kind of, but you can see here the alcohol is very, very low. But even it called as a stronger version kind of alcohol, it's called as a bitter ale. we call it, I can show is brown ale, the stronger version. Again, the stronger version may, this is a brown kind of a type of a beer where it has a little bit of sweetish and nutty flavor. Nutties are nothing but you can get cashew, ground nuts, like, you know, you get a, like, you know, pista, badam. These all are nuts, right? Examples. It's a nutty flavor and a little light sweetness in this. It comes from the Belgium. Basically, it's very famous in the Belgium. It comes from the Belgium. And why it has some sweet and sour taste? Because when you do it, like, you know, boiling stage, like, you know, lacquering or lacquering stage me, or like, you know, at time of, like, you know, boiling kind of thing, they try to boiler at the slow flame, slimmer it. They try to slimmer this process. By this, you extract the sourness taste and the sweetness will be getting into that by this hops. So that is the specialty of this beer, is brown ale, is that is a sweet and nutty and something called sweetish. And it's come from the Belgium. As the people like this beer, it also spread to the France and Germany also. This is called brown ale. The third category of this cream ale, it's very light. You can see the color. It looks like very light color. See the amber color, and, like, you know, when people say it's very light, but yes, it is a stronger version. It's always, it's just a copy version. People say it's a copy version of Pilsner. Pilsner is a kind of beer, light beer. The world likes the Pilsners. Pilsner is a type of beer. People of most of population, like most, it's one of the famous beers, Pilsner, light version. Man. So it's almost, the people say the copy version of that. But the fermentation happens on the top fermentation, where the Saccharomyces cerevisiae, the yeast been added into this. That is the reason it called as a stronger beer. And it is high in carbon. There are a lot of CO2 inside. That's the reason you can see the foam. When you open the beer, you can see the picture, the lot of foam inside in the picture. It's high on carbonation. It's also very sweetish, sweet, the smoothest, and the golden color. It's come in a golden or the amber color. And the specialty of this, they try to blend with the top fermentation, the bottom fermentation. This is basically the stronger beer away, top fermentation, right? They also try to mix with the beer, which is a bottom fermentation. That's nothing but lighter beer and stronger beer trying to be like a blend kind of thing. That is the reason it's a kind of a cream ale. It is a like copyright. It's almost same version of like Pilsner beer. Next one is Indian Pale Ale. This is a beer is made in England at the time of Britishers, when we are, like, you know, before the independence, where the Britishers used to control us. So they had a troops, Indian troops, to control this India. For them, they used to make a special beer, which is stronger, higher version of alcohol and more of hops, more stronger flavor and high end alcoholic percentage. They used to make specially for us, like Indians, for the Indian soldiers especially. And they used to make and they used to send to India for the Indian troops, as a part of the ration, as a part of the meat, as a part of that, like, you know, the candy, the kind of a ration they used to give them. The special, this Indian beer is made. Indian Pale Ale is called as. So you can see the bottle. It's a, like, you know, very high alcoholic, more strong flavor, more strong alcoholic flavor. It is made in England, especially with the troops of India before independence, like, you know, at the time of 19th century or 18th century, this beer is made and sent to India for the Indian soldiers as to give as a ration for them. So next one is Lambic Ale. It's a kind of a stronger, but it is very famous. It comes from the Belgium. So one of the best beers in the world you get from the Belgium. And where they are, like, you know, one of the flavorful, they're like, you know, Hoegaarden. The best example is Hoegaarden. It's a kind of a beer. Hoegaarden is not a coriander. It's a kind of a garden. The herbs of the garden. Will have a nice strong flavor of coriander. So one of the example I'm talking, Hoegaarden beer. You might be seeing in industry or, like, you know, in the market, you might be seeing this about this Hoegaarden beer. So still they consider as a lambic ale. It's one type of a beer. It's come from the Belgium basically. Okay, it's a type of beer come from the Belgium. The specialty of this is, number one, they try to use a natural yeast in this. They try to use a natural yeast. It's nothing but wild yeast. When they do the fermentation, they left open to the air. From the air, the natural, which is in air, which has a natural yeast, the wild yeast will fall on this fermentation, the tanks. And this yeast started reacting. By this, when the wild yeast falls, a lot of foam, the white milky kind of a foam will be have formed on this, like, you know, top surface. And as you know, this wild yeast is like, you know, white, it will be like one of the open tanks in this open fermentation. So this wild yeast will react this and form this air, fermentation start happening. And doing this, they try to use old hops, not as a fresh hops. They try to use as a preservative, the old hops, just for sake of preservatives, not for flavor. Basically, hops act like a preservatives and, like, you know, as a flavor. But especially these hops have been one of the older hops they try to use, sake of only preserve the beer. So in this third category is, they try to use this 30% of unfermented wheat, unmalted wheat, like, you know, generally in process of baking beer, we have a malted, we have a process called malting. Generally, we try to germinate, we try to, like, you know, malt and roast killing, this process. But unmalted is nothing, but we don't use any kind of process in this. This 30% of the worth, which is, like, you know, they take the grain, barley, they mix the directly, the mix into powder and mix with the 65% of water and boiled, is known as what? Unfermented, unmalted. This unfermented malt of 30% being mixed inside, such that the flavor to be attained, the balance, to balance the beer very nice, to make the beer well balanced and to make attain the very good flavors to taste to get the beer. That is nothing but lambic ale. It's one of the famous and one of the traditionally made. Still in Belgium, they follow this kind of method in Belgium. That is the reason one of the best beers in the world you get from the Belgium. Next one is porter ale. This kind of ale, porters, is basically charted malt. Charted is nothing but fired. The grain which is there, they've been fired. When we fire the grain, or the, like, roasted the grain, what happened? The flavor of this chattered, the oak flavor will be coming to that grain. So they try to use this chattered malt. They try to use this grain which is roasted, the flavor, a smoky flavor the malt will have. That is the specialty of this ported malt. And because of this strong flavor, it been having a bitter. They've been roasted, right? When you roast, you get, like, a more roasted, that's a bitter. When how much you roast, that much you get a dark color. That much you get a dark color, and the flavor also very strong flavor. And that is reason it has a called as a brown beer, and also in bitter in taste because of the roasting. The you more go into roast part into that, and also tastes in, like, in dark in taste, where brown color, dark in color. So it is made for this in London. So dockyard porter, the word, like, you know, in the shipyard, they have a porters, right? The people who used to, like, you know, workers, general labor in London, like in a shipyard, to work these people. They're, like, you know, more stronger version. That is the reason they made this stronger beer. The specialty of this is the grain. They have a more of charted flavor. I mean, at the time of malting, they used to roast very highly. By this roasting, they get a nice flavor, strong flavor, nice color, a stronger version of beer is made. And that is the reason it's called the porter. It's sake of porters, it is made called Porter Ale. The name given for the Porter Ale, found in 17, somewhere around 300 years back nearly. It is made in London. Next one is, I'm talking about Scotch Ale. It is from, it's come from the Scotland. The specialty of this is the strongly malt, the more of flavor. The more of malting is done in this, more of germination, like, you know, roasting, or like more of, like, you know, you're converting the sugar, the starch into sugar, and you'll keep roasting, like, you know, nice malting is there. The good enough malting is given to the barley, the roasting and the malted barley. That is the reason they have a very good malted flavor in this. The more of sweetness you can see in this, and they're more of darker version because of the roasted. It is found in, like, you know, bitter, it is found in Scotland, and more of bitterness, you can say, more of bitterness level, and it is very heavy, like, you know, in terms of, like, you know, body, it's very heavy, and taste wise is very light and special. It's one of the specially they call, and it is made more near to the hops, the fields. Hops, you know, that's a, like, you know, it's a kind of a seed, or, like, you know, it's from the humanist plants, it's a kind of a plants which वो नियर का फील्ड रहता है ना, द प्लांट्स का, हॉप्स का ट्रीज, दैट फील्ड नियर टू दैट फील्ड दिस ग्रोवरी इज टू मेक सो दैट दे हैव अ वेरी स्ट्रॉन्ग एंड फ्रेश फ्लेवर इज टू गिव टू दैट. So it's very light, like you know, it's a very dry. It's very dry and like in a medium kind of thing. It's very heavy. I hope you understand the Scotch ale. I repeat, the Scotch ale, it is made from Scotland because they use the fresh hops, and it is a malted, very strong malted. Malting has been done. They're very stronger, they consider, and more of bitterness because of the malting. It's more of bitterness and the lighter, like in terms of like, you know, taste wise, the sweetness is it's a medium, and with the in the body, they're very heavy. And always they try to use near to the hops field, the plant, the where the trees are grown, the hops, that near to that the breweries are is to make, or like, you know, they have the brewery nearby that area where the freshly made and cut and been used as hops to use a stronger version. Yes. This is called stouts. We are talking about, like, you know, as I told, ales. We are talking about porters, and this is a famous called Stout Ale. This is one of the famous beer called Guinness. Guinness is one of the famous beer in the darker version. See the color. See, it is very dark color, dark beer. So by this, you can easily identify it is that when the time of malting, it's a highly like, you know, dark kind of roasting it is made. The grain is made into very dark, fine kind of roasting. Example, espresso, coffee. You can see this coffee beans are darkly roasted. Why is this? What happened? You get that espresso, very strong, intensified and color. Same espresso coffee, very darker version. Same way here also, at the time of roasting, they go with a darker version. Complete the grain goes into dark roasting, where the beer get very dark color, high flavor, and also there are more hops also used to balance that, to hop flavors also you get into that. This is all about the stock beer, Stouts. And I'm talking about this one of the famous beer. It is come from the Germany. It's called Wibze. It is come from Germany. It's made from the beer. Nowadays the trend, it is having the beers are made with the wheat also. The one of the oldest beer, which they made with the wheat. The wheat is grain is taken, they malt the wheat grain, and 50 to 60% of malted wheat being used inside. And it has a lot of cloudy. When you drink the beer, it has a lot of like sediments you can see in this, because they don't go filtration. They don't unfiltered yeast. They never filtered this one. By this, you see the cloudy, and you see the lot of like, you know, a lot of foam you can see inside. It's a cloudy and the foam. And this is a specialty of the German beers, and it's called the Wips. It's made with the wheat, not instead of barley, they use the wheat here. The specialty is 50 to 60% of wheat is being used, wheat, malted wheat to be used compulsory. Rest can be anything, and especially in summer special, this is about the German beer. Now, I'm coming to the lager. There's a second type of beer, which is a lighter version of beer, I can call. So please remember, stouts, ales, and porters. Stouts, ales, and porters are called stronger version. This lager and pilsner are lighter versions of beer. Now I'm entering into the second type of quality beer. Is known as I call you, it's a lighter beer. We call it as a light beer. Again, I repeat you, based on the type of fermentation and the base of type of yeast we are going to add in this. So in this fermentation, what we use is we try to add the yeast name known as Saccharomyces cowlbergenis. Saccharomyces cowlbergenis. You can see the spelling here. See my cursor. Saccharomyces cowlbergenis is a kind of a yeast we try to add in the fermentation tanks. When we add this yeast, it goes directly bottom of the tank, fermentation tank. It settles down at the bottom of tank and start reacting. For this, we have to give the temperature 5 to 9 degrees. When we give this 5 to 9 degrees of temperature, when slowly the yeast started reacting and eat the sugar and release the ethyl alcohol and CO2. By this, the temperature should be at 5 to 9 degrees. This is also called as bottom fermentation. This is also called as bottom fermentation. And it is called as a lagering. How this lager is known as lighter beer. How this word has come? This word is known as come from the German word it is lager. Lager is nothing but to store. This to store this to get water, like you know, to get a like you know storage from storage. Lager is a lager. That's how the name came into the existence of this lager beer. So I hope you understand how this lighter version of beer is came or existence to the world. We have few different types of lager beer, lighter versions. So we have Dock, Dockmunder, Dunkel, Ice Beer, Pilsner, which is world famous, Mazarin, and Vanillia. These are types of beers. So let's go and see how these types of beers are lighter beers are made. So I'm talking about Dock Lager. It come from the Germany. In every year, you might be seeing this news or like you know articles in the time of October or like you know November in spring season basically. So they have food like in Germany they have festival called as a Oktoberfest. This kind of a festival they try to make in Germany. The people who love the beer, they try to come to travel that places. They try to make nearly 4 to 5 thousand varieties of beers, types of beers they make, different types of beers they make. So to taste that kind of a beers, the people come all over world around to attend that fest actually. It happened in the spring season in the month of October or like you know November. So it is basically it's a, from there it's especially made that kind of that's due to this festival the Dock Lager beer is special in that actually in festival if you go that what you get is Dock Lager. It's a kind of a beer. This is stronger beer. It's a kind they call it a stronger kind of a version, but it is a sweet. The specialty of the beer is after you taste and you see the sweetness in your mouth. You see the sweetness in mouth. Example. You see this amla, gooseberry. You crush your gooseberry in your mouth and you just chew. After chewing, you get some sweetness in your mouth. You see the a kind of a sweetness in that kind of a appearance, or that kind of a, like you know mouth feeling you get after tasting this Dock Lager beer. So this is special actually. So how to identify this? There are a lot of variations. They have a bull goat. Bully goat is a kind of a goat which like you know they have a bullies around the goat which is like you know they have like a honks kind of thing. So these goats have been fight kind of thing. This is a kind of a symbol. This is especially for this Dock Lager. This we get in the spring season, especially in the Germany. This is one of the specialty of that festival. The stronger version. There's a 6 to 10% of alcohol. It is a light golden color. It's a come in a golden beer, golden color, and it is a sweet. The specialty of this is you see the sweetness after the drinking the beer. That is a specialty of Dock Lager. The next one is Dockmunder. Dockmunder. Those are high level of malt. When the type of a roasting the grain, they try to go very highly roasted. They try to give the complete of germination, completing the sugar, the starch is converting into sugar. Okay. Complete, there's no sugar left over inside. They complete go into fermentation, they go high roasting. So by this way, you get a high malt. There's no sugar at all. And a strong flavor, strong color, and it is full body. It's like, you know, full flavor. There's no sweetness. High flavor, high color, high taste. Like in a more darker version, just like espresso coffee. I can give a best example, espresso kind of a coffee. But alcohol is only 5% of this because of the yeast fermentation. It is full. That is the reason we call a full body. In terms of it is a dry. There's no sweet at all. So strong flavor is very strong flavor. But in terms of aroma, it is very less. The hops have been added very less. It has a very less flavor compared because already high flavor is dominating. Even in roasted, it is highly roasted. The flavor is very roasted. So it's a dominating. There's a you see the less flavors inside. There's not much of like you know any other flavor, the ginger or like you know. You don't see any floral or any chili. You don't see any kind of flavor inside. But because it's a highly roasted kind of highly malted, it, you only see the malt flavor inside more. That's a specialty of Dock Munder. Third type of beer is Dunkel. Dunkel, it's very soft beer. The people call it very soft, brown color, brown malt. It's like in a third kind of roasting, third kind of a level of roasting you do inside, in the chocolate kind of roast you do. It's called as a brown malt roasting, where it is called German. It's a come from the Germany. It's a, they call it one of the soft beer. Okay. It's like, you know, about like, you know, third category. I can say about in medium, say above medium. Like it's, I can say like, you know, out of 100%, 70-80% I can call the way of malty. So people say it's a still brown, brown malted beer, but it's a soft kind of a beer they call it. Next one, see my cursor, is called ice beer. This ice beer, nearly 40 years back, or like 20, 30 years back, it is found actually. What is the specialty of this beer is, at the time of fermentation, they chill the beer. They go into frozen kind of, they almost froze the beer. Nearly they go into like, you know, chilling. Chill the beer. Very low temperature, they drop to nearly 2 to 3 degrees, or nearly to almost in frozen stage. By this, what happened? Any particles, still we cannot see with our naked eye, any small particles, a powder form kind of, they went into frozen. They got into frozen state. If example, dust is there, some yeast, dead yeast is there. That yeast get into frozen, rock ho jayega, into getting solid form. When you go passes from filtration, the ice crystal will remain there. The small ice crystal, we cannot even we see with the naked eye, those ice crystal will stop. By this, you get a one of the small best beer you get. This kind of innovation found in 1990s, nearly 30 years back, this kind of traditional, sorry, this kind of a latest techniques are found chilling the beer. This part is ice beer. Okay, this is one of the purified beer, smooth beer, and clear, crystal clear beer. This call is ice chill beer, ice beer. Okay, so next one, I'm going with a Marzen. Marzen is a kind of a made in the Germany. It's a malted aroma. You can see the malted rope, highly malted flavor inside, and amber light golden color. It's not much, it's come from Germany. Okay, Venia, it's a kind of a country. It's come from the Venezuela. Venia, it's a kind of a country. Where you come from that country? It's a light golden color. It's a one type of beer. It's a lager. It's very light version. Now I'm coming to the one of the famous to the Pilsners. Pilsner is come from the Germany. Is found in 1842. One of the best light beer people love to have this Pilsner. It has a specialty of aroma, very nice aroma, and golden hop. It's a light golden color and hoppy, flow hoppy, like, you know, flower taste, flower kind of aroma you get into taste, into flavor into that. And because of the hops are used, the sweetness is down there because of hops, very good hops, floral taste. The hops are used. You get a nice flower taste, but because of the hops are used, the sweetness is dropped back. So it's very dry. It is dry, high, very high floral taste you get in this. That is called Pilsner beer. And it is very smoothest taste you get. Smooth malt, or smooth because of the light version of malting, to get a smooth taste into that. There's a description about the Pilsner beer. You can try, those are one of the famous and the world famous people love to have the Pilsner beers. Okay, this is all about the types of beers. Till now, what we discuss is the stronger version beer and the lighter version beer, and what kind of process of fermentation involved, and this what kind of process of fermentation involved. So what kind of yeast and different what kind of yeast, what happened with this kind of beer, and what are the different types of beers we get, and what is the flavor, color, taste impact will there on the types of beers we see till now. Okay, next subtopic I'm going into call is the storage of beer. Storage of beer, see the colors, how different colors of beers you can get. See this. This is a light golden color. See, in this golden color also we have two, three varieties. One, two. This is orange color. Something is called as a darker, where you go at the high kind of roasting, you get the brown color, the brown ale. This is called the golden color. This is a perfect combination of amber color. This is called as a ale. and there's a light golden color. This is a dark version. So this is a dark version where the high version of roasting you done the grain. So this is a basic ideology behind the malting impact on the beer. Now the new topic is I'm coming to the storage of beer. Number one, it should be well ventilated, because you should be provided, not like in putting in a sun or you're not putting in open air. You should have some oxygen to pass around. There should be, it should not be like, you know, complete packed air, because when you, the it also affect the quality of beer. So a light ventilation should be there. Air should be passing around, but not like a blowing air should be there. A good ventilation, kind of a good sunlight, a good lighting, and a good lighting should be there. Good air pass around air should be there. And that is the reason you always store in cellars. Cellars, basically, we try to store in underground, like minus one kind of a floor under the ground. Because the impact of sun, the sunlight or the air or the heat, the coming from the sun or some, the impact will be there on the quality. This might be affect the quality of the beer. That is the reason we try to store in the cellar. And the maintain, the temperature of the cellar should be maintained 13 to 15 degrees. I'll tell you what impact will be there. When you put a good sunlight fall on the beer, what happened? It is fermented. It has like protein. When sun falls, sun is nothing but heat. When heat fall on the beer, when the protein start coagulating, start getting into coagulated, you start see the change of a taste or the small sediments in, you see in the beer. That is the reason sunlight is avoided. You might observe the most of the beer is in darker bottle, the dark color bottle, not in a plain, mostly, if you observe that. Why? Because they don't want to pass the sunlight to fall on the beer. They want to cut the rays of the sun so that no heat will be fall on that. When the heat fall, there is a great chance of taste we may change. So that is the reason dark bottles are used. Second one, the quality of air. Air has some, air also carry a flavor. Example, when you keep the store near to the ocean, ocean has a salt, the air has a very dry moisture, that kind of taste might be, impact will be there on beer. If suppose you might be storing at somewhere at mountains or caves, you see the impact of taste will be something else, because the air also matters. That air also carry the molecules, the water, the moisture levels, the flavor, that also impact might be there on the beer. That is the reason we always try to store on the, and why the maintain a temperature of 13 to 15 here, because in underground also the heat come from the ground. If the heat come from the ground, there might be impact will be there. So that is the reason temperature always should be there on 13 to 15 degrees. And that is the reason never ever store on the ground. You always try to put on the racks. The beer always store in the, see the picture, the beer always store in the racks always. Not directly touch the ground. Okay, now they, how they store? They always store in the bottles. Whenever you're storing in the storage, you have to be very careful. You have to check the bottle, whether it is broken, whether the seal of the bottle is open or any breakage is there. You have to check. Then you have to admit this beer into your stocks. Because when you're traveling, there's a great chance, because when transportation, the vehicle might be like, you know, movement will be there. So by this, what happened? The CO2 impact will be there. When you open the bottle, might be CO2 will be coming out very fast. It will be like, you know, foam will come out. That impact will be there always on the beer. So that is reason you have to check how the seal of the cap, it is like, you know, it is good, or any damage or the brokage is there of the neck of the bottle. Then you have to take into your control, or you need to admit into your stock levels. And let me speak on the beer shelf life. Beer shelf life will be maximum 6 months. In general, it will be 6 months. But even it does not spoil, but it lost its place, freshness of the beer, it has flavors in the beer it lost. You might be seeing there's a no, you don't enjoy the taste of much of beer after 6 months. It does not spoil, but you don't enjoy it. It almost like, maximum shelf life will be, the beer will be 6 months, not more than that. Point number one. You might also know the draft beer. Draft beer, generally, the draft beer we use in the pubs or the bars, which is freshly brew, freshly the CO2 carbonated and given and services made. What is specialty of this draft beer? Draft beer is not heated, not pasteurized. This milk is pasteurized milk. So here the beer is not heated or cooled. It has a microbacterial is there in this draft beer. Why it is not heated? Because to not taste freshness of beer, the taste of the beer to remain, the aroma in the beer to remain, that is the reason the not pasteurization is not from the draft beer. As it is not pasteurized, the life will be only 3 days maximum. Once a kegger, the basically draft beers all come in the kegs, KEDGS. It's a kegs. The capacity of the keg is 10 gallon. The 1 gallon is 4.56 liters. 4.56 liters. Nothing but 4 point is near to 4 liters. Nothing but 45 liters. One keg will be 45 liters nearly. Nothing but once you open the keg, 45 liters at a time, you need to consume this 45 liters in 3 days maximum. Or it is refrigerated, it is put in the refrigerator, then it is no problem. It can hold up to 1 month. It is you're not putting in the refrigerator this kegger, it will spoil in 3 days. So that is always you need to be very careful. And that is the reason the perishable of life of the draft beer is very low. And that is the reason and why the people still love to have the draft beer, because it has a freshness in beer and it has a very good flavors. The people enjoy the flavor, but because it is not pasteurized, the microbacterial is present inside the beer. That is a negative point, is that the shelf life of the beer tend to spoil very fast. Maximum in refrigerator, it can hold up to 1 month, not more than that. So this is all about the topics today, what we discussed. I repeat, I just jot down the points. We discussed about two topics here. Number one, type of the beer. Number two, storage of the beer. So type of beer is, we talk about a strong beer and light beer. We have a different varieties in that. We discussed on few points, the flavor, the color, the taste, and the alcoholic percentage, how the impact will be there on each and type of beer. Next subtopic, we discussed about storage of beer. When you store the beer, how to be caution, how to be careful to be storage of beer, you need to keep in the points. Any doubts, or I hope you understand this class. Any doubts, you can ask me. And thank you. I hope you enjoy this class.